I think that many of you know me. I'm John Shabani, so I come from Congo, DRC. So our presentation begins. I want to just to introduce a little bit Congo and the Great Apes habitat, and we can see that the importance of Congo and why we focus or we do many things in DRC, like as AGI. So, but the presentation also, you see the name, the Mark, Fourier, Lilian, Debbie. So there are so many people who contribute in this presentation. So it's not Johnny's presentation, I can say it's for a team presentation. So this is Congo there in this area. And we are there in this East DRC, there we are Goma, so it is there our office are. But if you look very well at this area, you'd see the forest. So we have Congo have 68% of Congo Basin forest. So that means 52% of the country is just forest. So other countries like Congo Brazzaville, Gabon also have some part of Congo Basin forest, but 68% is in DRC. So that means we have also this great place that many great apes are, because whatever we share chimpanzee with other country, but you can see that we have more than 80% of great apes in Congo. But also we have 100% of Grauer gorillas, bonobo, and also we share with Rwanda and Uganda the gorilla berigei, that we call many times mountain gorilla in East. So there are in Virunga, but also in Rwanda and in Uganda. So we have four species of great apes in our country. So it's just two that we didn't find in Congo. So for that, we can say that we have not just that this great place and habitat of chimpanzee, but we have also that big responsibility to protect them. But if I want to just to focus in our area, for now we are focused in East DRC, so it is really big, is like France, if you know. So this area take four provinces, Maniema, North Kivu, South Kivu, and the Oriental province. So there are in this area chimpanzees are everywhere, because also it is a forest. But in this map you can see where we can find gorillas, and in this area we find Grauer gorilla just in Kauzi Biega. But there they found also other species, gorilla, berigei. So in July this year, so I want to say about this trade map. In 2010, 70 stakeholders have a meeting in Goma. JGI and Disney helped at that meeting, and we have that we call the Great Apes Conservation Action Plan. So in that experts see what kind of threats great apes are. So this is a new one. We do that in this year in July. So, but whatever we change and we do many jobs in these 5 years, but the commercial hunting still the high threat to great apes. But the second is loss of habitat. So that is our big two challenge that we faced in Congo. Whatever we have other challenge, but the first is this hunting, and second loss of habitat. So there I want just to show you a little bit some picture. You can see how the situation are. So in this picture, you can, you know, they smoke bushmeat and they mix it with other species because they know that great apes are protected. So what they do, they smoke that and mix with other monkeys. So it is difficult for security to arrest them. But in February, I was in the field and I take this picture. So that is a chimpanzee in a market. So you can see this is the real situation of the forest in that area. So the second thing that I say is about a lot of forest. And in this map, we thank really Lillian for this map. This area, we have many, many cities in this area, in the border with Uganda and Rwanda and Burundi. So if you can look very well, the green, this is, we have a little bit dark green, but when we go in east, you can see that forest is really lost. But this is the situation in 2010. 2 years, in 2012, we take the same picture, but why we do that? Because in this time, we have peace in Congo for 2 years. So in red, you can see in just that 2 years, the loss of habitat. That is the situation. But now, we haven't war. The war is finished. Now, I think that the situation is a little bit more alarming than this. But you can see that the loss is around main roads and cities. Here is Kisangani and Beni, Butembo, so it is that area that we saw. So what did JJ do? I think, guys, we know, you know, our African program, we have this six area. The first is women and health in the environment in DRC. That is, I think, the first program that we start to support health system, family planning, and now also we build some clinics, we provide some material in clinic, and I think that there are some more other things that we do. I didn't really know many things about this because it's not my program, but I know many things that we do with that. The second area is that we work with to support sanctuary like Luiro, Grace, and also we support the national park, Kauti Biega and Maiko. But also we have eight local reserves that they have an association called Yugadec that also we support. Now we also started this, I think 2 years now, because people lost everything and they need alternative to bushmeat. So also in that area we started this. And this program, the Earth Habitat, now we begin it a little bit because now we work with local people in land use plan. And we try to help them to understand what they can do, what they can, where they can use, for example, where they can use land for farm or live for animals and so on. But this is just, we just started. This is are connected with this science and technology because now we have our research program that will begin a little bit slowly. But JJ and the Arcus Fund give many support to WWS who do this many survey for us. So my program, and this is we'll talk more, is about the education program. So as I said first, we started this program is a part of a strategy from the Great Apes Conservation Action Plan. This document, you can find it in internet because they are available. So in this document, stakeholders take many strategies to protect the great apes in SDRC. But one of them is the education program. So in this year also, they changed a little bit some some objectives on the, we focus more now again to involve people, involve people to the conservation action. We use Miradi for that, and in 2012, one of activity that we do, JGI and ICCN, and it is the government branch for conservation, we developed this environmental education strategy plan, because we want to know exactly what we will do if we want to teach people. And another thing is JGI leads the education program in East DRC for all stakeholders. Whatever education ministry, environmental ministry, or other conservation NGO, when they want to do something about education program, they must ask us, because some of them are funded by Disney and so on. So many of material that we develop, it is the same thing that they do. Like also posters, they come to JGI, take our posters, and we send them posters, t-shirts, and everything. So we share with all stakeholders the same message in this area. So this document also, for now, haven't reached JGI level, because we ask that to be for everyone. For the background of that education program, many of you know Tammy. So in 2009, they start with that meeting that I talk about, Great Apes Conservation Action Plan, but they focus in education. So they ask JGI and Disney to help how they can we can develop the same message and materials for education program. So since 2010, each year we have this meeting. We train educators and other NGOs workers who have education program. But also for JGI, we have 11 educators who are trained, and there are every day in field work with local people, but also with our some schools that are involved in directly in our program. So, but before we start our program, we also need to understand or to know what is the situation before start that program. So we have this need assessment in 2010 in Walikale area. But when we talk about Walikale area, you know that includes also Lubutu. So this is what we find, that 94% of people agree that they eat bushmeat, and they know that. And also, they know that is illegal. But the good thing it was that the 96% of people agree that it is important to aware people, to teach them about great apes, and that can help them to be more involved in protection of great apes and their habitat. So our program is I can say is in a cycle, a continual cycle thing. So the first thing, we focus in improve knowledge of people. When we know that when the knowledge is improved, they can also influence their attitude, and after that, influence also improve their behavior. So it is this kind, and when their behavior is improved, also we can improve again the knowledge and continue in the same thing. So, but this is our area. I want just to present you Walikale area. Yeah, because thank you. So Congo is so big. So you can see there. This is the area that we work for now. So we didn't work in everywhere. So this is Walikale area. But why this area is so important for us is, you can see there are Maiko National Park. It is one of the big national park in Congo and is protected. We can find there gorilla chimpanzee, but also okapi. And this area is Taina, a natural reserve. There starts like a local conservation activity, initiative, but after that, they ask the government to protect this area because there are also many gorilla are really in danger in this area. So the government saw that it is be important to change it and protect this area. And here we have Kahuzi-Biega National Park. So we have a kind of crossing area, because when you are in this area, whatever Maiko or Kahuzi-Biega is protected, and if you are in Walikale, it's so difficult to know if you are in a national park or not, because the forest is the same. So, and I know that animal didn't care if you protect or not that area, so they cross every time this area. So that put them in a really dangerous situation, because people can keep them in this area and they say, no, they are not in national park. So many picture that you see is around this area. But the good thing in this area is this, you see like a blue there, is local initiative that we call local reserve. So local people and traditional chief start some conservation. They want to protect their area and forest. So they start this, and we have nine reserve in this area. And they have a network that they call UGADEC, the Union of Gorilla Association for Development of Community in East DRC. So this UGADEC, I can say it is our big partner, because we work in the UGADEC area. But the dangerous also, the another important thing that we see, it is this road. Mobutu, the former president Mobutu, built a good road from Walikale to Kisangani. And this road connects not just Kisangani and Bukavu, but there are also a road to Goma and another road from Lubutu to Kindu. So Kisangani have more than 3 to 4 million people, and all eat bushmeat, many of them. And Kindu have around 500 people. And there in Goma, we are around 1 million people. And Bukavu, more than 2 million people. So that means this road is a big bushmeat trade road. So what we do first in this road is to put this kind of what do you do? Yeah, this stuff. So the area that you see black, we put this kind of billboard. So when we talk about billboard, because there are no billboard there, nothing. So, and we know that car cross that road, and you see, if you see very well, it is a good road. So, and they kill just animals around this forest and they sell them to car that they cross this road. So what we do is to put this kind of billboard in that road, in checkpoints, and we help also police and ICCN and other service to monitor and to control the animals that they can see in this area. So this is a map of schools. We have now 120 schools involved in our program. So this, I thank very so much our Mark and other people who do this map for us. They take GPS data and so on, and they put so we can see all schools and other schools here in Punia area. But that is the reality of school that I told. There are many schools there, but it is an area that faced 20 years of war. So all infrastructure are destroyed, schools, clinics, and everything. So what we find like school is kind of things like this, or teachers there, and children, and this is. And if you can see very well there, it's really open. So if they're running, children must go at all. at home. So can you imagine that area that they're running every time? So that means children must go every time at home and they cut the school. So this is kind of a former school, but it was also destroyed. So you can see that situation. That so many times when we work with our educators there and they say, okay, you work very well. We set out to protect the animals. So what you can you do for our children and so on, communities? I ask it as many times in that question. So thanks many donors who start now to help us, because this is one of good things that also helps people to understand conservation is not just for animals in forest, but that they are also connected. And in this area, the other thing that people have, they didn't understand conservation, because the conservation started there many years, but in period of colonialism and dictatorship. So Mobutu, in the time of Mobutu, he will come in an area because he loves so much animals. And he can say, now Washington is a national park. So he didn't care if people are there. And he sent military there and everybody must go. So it is that kind of things that he do. And people didn't understand why, what is the importance of conservation. But now with education and activity like this, people now understand that conservation is good. And since we start some kind of activity like this, it's not just build school, but also we provide them materials, books, and also we do the same thing with clinics. So now people understand more, and they understand now conservation is not just for some kind of people who love so much animals and come here to tell us to protect their animals, but also they know that this is can help us and can connect us. So children there sing many songs that they say, Rafikietu Sokomutu. So that means our friend chimpanzee built for us school and so on. Because the campaign that we do with this, it is also a tool. So we say to children, if you have this good school, it's not because of anything. It's because you are involved and your parents protect animals, especially chimpanzee. So they understand this school, if they have it, is because of conservation. So in short, our education program has many areas or many activities. First, that I told, we are in schools, primary schools, and also we have our 11 educators in 11 sites. When I talk about site, it is one area, but there are so many villages in that same area. So also we put billboards, as I show you. We distribute t-shirts with environmental message, posters, and also magazines. We have also four radio programs. This is so important because there are no roads there, no television, no electricity, no telephone. So there are many people who are not around that big road. There are in forest, and it is so difficult to reach them there in forest. So the only way that we are sure that they receive our message is from radio, because also many people there buy radio and have radio, because it is the only way that they can receive some message from or connect with their relative. For example, if there are a good news or a bad news, they receive it from radio. So it is for them important every day to listen radio. So we use it for education program. This is the secretary of UGADEC. So it is one of tradition chief who also help us in this program. So putting billboard is not simple, because when we put billboard, people think this, that we buy or we take their land. So it's important, before I put any billboard, I must talk with everybody, especially women. Because women in village, it is them who are really connected with the land. So they are a little bit afraid, because when we come with all messages, they say, perhaps they arrest us or not. We didn't do, for example, agriculture around the billboard, or they want to change our land to become a national park and so on. So there are some afraid for that. So we have also community meeting, 11 community meeting each month to talk and to receive also their idea about what we do. So it is from this community meeting, everything that JGI do or provide, for example, livestock and so on, come from there. It is there they can decide, give us chicken or not. If they don't, they say, no, we don't like chicken here. It is impossible for us to do that because we know that that community didn't want that. But also, it is a really difficult meeting because many times when I meet with people there, they say to me, you come here to tell us to stop eat bushmeat and we haven't alternative. So we must really have a good communication with them, and I can say it is really the almost dangerous thing that many times when I am there and I talk to educators, don't say anything because we don't. Sometimes people make some promise, and if you promise these people something and you didn't realize it, it's really dangerous for us. So this is why we do this meeting.
Can I go back on the last point, do you personally go to all of those meetings every month?
No, I go in some of them, but we have a monthly message. And before any meeting, I have meeting with educators. So we tell them what they will, we say what they will do. For example, if it is a month that we want to talk about chimpanzee, so all messages will be about chimpanzee. So all questions, it will be about chimpanzee. But they can receive other questions from community, but they are not allowed to answer. They can just say, okay, we take it and we say it to JDI. Okay. So also me, when I receive that message, some question, I haven't also answered. So I must back in Goma and ask also others about it. And when I receive answer about that, we can back in a meeting or talk about that in radio, because the meeting and the radio have the same message each month. So if we talk about the importance of forest in radio, it is the same thing that we talk with them in meetings. So it is that we do. So in short, you can see our program there. This is the number of children that in Walikale area we reach each month. And now we are around this number every year, more than 25,000 children that there are exposed to this program.
Do you think it's a big number or a small number? Do you feel like you've got most of the schools or most of the important schools? Or?
So for ourselves is. It's not big and it's not small. I can say that big because there are so many children. For example, this number of children, all children there go in their family and take to their parents. So we have many stories from many parents who say to us, we stopped to eat bushmeat because children didn't want to eat bushmeat because they are teachers about that and they change their attitude. I have a story from the inspector of education from Lubutu. He's one of the biggest person, and I think that he didn't eat bushmeat or something. But one day in a workshop, he said to us, you know, I stopped to eat bushmeat. I said, oh, great. Why that? He said, no, my children one day come, they back to at home and say to me, from today, we didn't eat again bushmeat. And I think that they joke. And so we buy for them bushmeat. And children didn't eat. And they said to their mom, we tell you that we didn't eat bushmeat again. We stopped. So you can buy for us chicken and other things, but not bushmeat. And the mom said to his husband that your children didn't want to eat today because they said they didn't eat bushmeat. And he said, oh, I think that they joke. And the second day after some weeks, buy again bushmeat, and children didn't eat. And they go to their father, and they say to them, we didn't eat bushmeat. We told you that we stopped to eat bushmeat because it's bad. And you are teacher. So he feel really bad, and he say, since today I didn't eat again bushmeat. So when we say it is a big number, because all children make something and do different in the area. But it's small because in this area we have more than 3,000 schools. So, but we work in 120. So you can understand. And many of our schools is around the road, the big road. We didn't go in forest. For example, in 5 kilometers in forest, it's so difficult to go there. So there we send just posters, just t-shirts, and some educators there. And there are so many other schools in some big village that they are not involved in our program. So it is important for us to reach everybody, but I know that it is impossible to do that also. But that is, I can say, it is big because there are so many people now who help us to reach their parents, but it's small because Congo is so big. So, but whatever we have also children, but the important thing is that we train also teachers. So each year we train teachers. So for now, I can say we are around 150 each year, so 2,000 every year. Since this June this year, we already teach 177. But you can see in this area, this kind of color, is the university students who we train. In Root and Shoot program, we take a special program with Root and Shoot students from university. And we teach them the same thing that we train teachers. Why? Because there are leaders for their village. You know, a student from university, when he go in village, in Congo, everybody listen what he would say. So it is important for us to teach them to be leaders and to understand very well. So they help us. It is for that now Root and Shoot go so quickly, because they start already Root and Shoot in their village because they are trained also. So their number growing so quickly, and there are, I can say, they help also teachers to be understood, because when teachers are there, is a local person and other person sort of the same, we know you and so on. But when another person come and say the same thing, there are, is like he helped that teacher to be more understood by the community. So this is another other result that we have. We now, this is a great thing that we meet these women. We start with one woman and two, there are now many, so we put them in two associations, and there are former traders of bushmeat, so they stop to trade bushmeat and put posters in their restaurants, many markets and so on, and they didn't again sell or buy bushmeat. So we have also hunters who accept and they publicly renounce. I think there are someone who come in Congo and take a video from one of Anta. So I don't know. We didn't receive that video, but I think if we Arcas have it, okay. So this is our Root and Shoot. They plant trees and so on. We have now this number of Root and Shoot group. That when I back in first time when I go in Congo, we just start with 3 person. So we are.
What year did you go back?
When I go for this, I back in Congo for the first time. It was in 2007. Yeah, but there we start something like Root and Shoot. But the really Root and Shoot started in 2010. But now we have 6,000 members. So you asked me about our basketball academy. This is our basketball players. So they're here in Goma. So every time we talk about what exactly they can use sports for conservation, so many times when they play and so on, they already have our posters and have that message. And sometimes we use microphone when they play and give people message. So I think, in short, that is our work in this 5 years. So what we do in next, that I say that they change, we change now, we review the Great Apes Action Plan, and we have now new objectives. But for education, first we must increase our scope, because Walikale, now the conservation, the status of Great Apes and their habitat is a little bit improved, because people understand it's difficult in Walikale to find any Great Apes or something that people take. And if you do that, children directly or anybody can say to us, and directly local authorities, security, they will arrest them. So the number of bushmeat also in market really, really decreased. So I have picture in 2011, and now is really completely different. Sometimes we go in that market and we didn't find any bushmeat. But the pressure come around Walikale now, from Kisangani, from Goma, Bukavu, Kindu. So that is, sometimes I talk to people, Sean, I say to them, Sean, I know that we have many problems, but JGI in the DRC, we have not willing but obligation to grow. We must grow in Congo, because if we didn't do this, whatever we say that we can protect chimpanzee in that crossing area, many pressure come out of that area, and they will continue to kill this. So we think that we increase the scope, also continue to increase the capacity of our educators, continue our, we must do the post evaluation in Walikale area to know now, we do that in 2010, so now what is the status in that area, for what the feeling, the knowledge, attitude and practice of people and local communities, great apes and their animals and other animals. But also now the government asks us to introduce the education program in the national curriculum, but we must start with SDRC. So many times we have meeting with ministers in national and local province level, and they appreciate so much our program, so they want it to be in all school. So just because we have just 120 school, but they need it in all school, so we must include that program in national curriculum. So it is that something that we already start with Debbie, and I must go or see what they do in Uganda and Tanzania, because there are already this program in their national curriculum, and see what we can do in Congo. So we already start meetings, but also we must involve these guys, politicians and authority in this program, and we must also increase focus in humane education. This is so important, because since we teach us this and local community, now they understand that there are connected. Because first, when we talk about them of about this, they say, "Ah, did you think chimpanzees are important than people, humans?" So for now, with this, they understand they are connected. And also, we must conduct some need assessment in other areas, because we do that just in Walikale, so we can do that in Kisangani, in other areas. So there are our many donors and also partners who we really thanks with. We really say Asante Sana for to them. So thank you. So it's that our job. So if guys you have some questions, I'm there for you.
Tell us one of your a special story. One of your experiences working in intelligence.
My special story, also I have this so many. I have so many, but one of that is that when I was in Disney, I don't know that they give one of gorilla that we risk in Lubutu. They give them the name of Lubutu. I didn't know that. So, but it's children who help us to have that information. I just talked with children about that in a school, and it was our first year there. So, and they said to us, it's better to take a chimpanzee or a gorilla. I said, yes. And then one children said, no, but I know someone who has a chimpanzee. So, but when we go there, it's not a chimpanzee, it's a baby gorilla. So we contact the authorities and so on, so they take that gorilla, and now he is in Greece. So I can say I have so many, many stories about that, but for myself, I can say that it is like a dream. And I know that I caused many problems and trouble to Jen and you guys and just Steve, because in 2000, when I go and say to Jen, we want to start root and shoot in Congo, so it was a little bit crazy. Because
Jane always refers to when she tells the story of the young person she met in the group.
Yeah. So really, it is was crazy, but something that was so amazing. It is the time when Jen came there, because in 2002, I tell them, Jen, we'll start root and shoot in Congo. And he say, wow, I think it is good, but I don't know if anyone can help you, because many donors will tell me there are war there, we must wait. So I said to them, okay, but we'll see what we can do. But I really know that we must start this. And my dream is one day, not in Kinshasa, but in East DRC, Jen will come and root and shoot members will be the first who greet you in Congo. In East DRC, that now is really completely a crazy area, because in that time, Congo was divided in four areas. So East DRC is under RCD rebel group. So it is them who lead that area. So first thing that Congo will be a one country in that time, it was like impossible in that time. So but I say we'll be in Congo one day, and you will come then. So and every time I have this picture of them when she come for the first time in my this is and you know what she said to me? It's just she said to me, John, what do you think now? I say, oh, I don't know. And I said to you, did you remember what I said to you? Never give up. If you didn't give up, you would see one day your dream become true. And today is root and shoot member who come greet me in the border. So for me it was, I can say, the greatest thing that I saw, that after more than 10 years, I have a little bit chance more than Martin Luther King, because he didn't see a dream. But me, I see my dream that I said, Jen will come in East DRC. But, and he's there, and now we have this root and shoot members, and many of them do many, many, many good things. And I think now, because I'm so happy that I have an assistant now in my office, so we can share with you many stories from Root and Shoots group there, many things that they do. And you can see that Jen inspired many persons. So the vision of Jen is so big. So that is, I can say there are so many things to say, and I talk so much. So it's so many.
John, can you talk about the connection between environmental education and roots and shoots a little bit?
Yeah. As okay, that is also some important thing. Education program is theory. There are, because we focus on to knowledge, to give people more information and to help them to understand the importance of conservation, especially for great apes and their habitat. So many times we talk to people about that it's important to plant trees, to protect great apes and so on. But we stop there. We give them posters, we give them t-shirts, and we stop there. But who now plants tree? Who now say, okay, I want to take plastic bags and so on and collect them, is root and shoots. So when we talk about education program in school and so on, people want to take action, and people who take action is root and shoots groups. So now I can say root and shoot is really a good impact of education program that we have. So it is so connected. We know we can tell people many things, but we know who do that is root and shoots. So some root and shoots groups start themselves some small livestock program, whatever, they didn't have any person to help them. I find some children in Walikale, and they say to me, we want to show you our chickens. A root and shoots group. There are just children, so they start things like that. In an area that people know that is just simple, you go in the forest, kill the animals, and come and have meat. But they start things like that. They plant a tree. Because we have livestock program, and we have two big nursery, but it is children who take that tree and plant in their house around the school. But also the other thing that is so important that I can talk about root and shoot, when we talk about education, environmental education, we are so more focused about great apes and so on. But root and shoots also put another importance about peace. You know, we are in the area that we have many victims, so there are many young that are so talk just about violence and so on. But it's in root and shoots that we change this vision. I can talk with them my story, how I changed before I met Jen, or before I was a root and shoots member. Who am I? But now, who I am now? So it is amazing. But because I see other young in the same situation, but because there are now root and shoots members, they start something that I never imagined before. I have an example of our national root and shoots coordinator. When we was M23 war, the M23 rebels are really, really supported. And many of military are Rwandese military, so they come, and we know that it is Rwandese army who support that. So what that creates in Congo, but especially in Goma and many area, is people, especially young people, talk just about violence, and they say, we need weapons, we want to go in Rwanda and fight. But a root and shoots club in university that Dr. Jen visits, they say, we do something for peace. And they 5 members go in Kigali. And they didn't tell us, they didn't tell JJ. Perhaps if they tell me, I will tell them I'm a little bit afraid, because we are, in that time, we are really in bad relation between Congo and Rwanda. But that young people go in Rwanda, and they contact some friend, and they say, okay, can you contact other friend? We want to talk about our relation, and what you young person in Rwanda think about war in Congo. And we tell you also what Congo is feeling. So they change many information, and what they saw, that many people in Rwanda didn't know if their army is involved in Congo. They don't know. So it is for them, Congolese people are crazy because they don't know why Congolese want to attack us because we didn't do anything bad. And also, many people in Congo didn't know, especially they didn't know that there are many Rwandans who didn't know anything about that war. It's just politicians who are involved in that. So what they do is to bring other Rwandans to come in Goma, because many of them say to them, we want to come in Congo to visit you, but we are so afraid because people will kill us. And they say, no, nobody will kill you because there are so many Rwandans there. So there are no communication between young people from Congo and Rwanda. So they took some friends and come with them and show them they can stay in Congo without any problem. And that is something that Rutten should do without our support, without anything. So one day I was in my office, just I saw some Rwandans come and said they want to greet me. I said, oh my God, what happened? And they said to me, no, you know, we are in contact with some Rutten Shoots group and so on, so we want to see where is the JGI office. And it was so great for me. And I saw Frank and I asked them, did you know them? They said, yes, we go in Kigali. So they tell me about that story. I said, whoa, it's great. But if we think also what Dario do with children in that promogen basketball, it's the same thing. He takes children from Gisenyi, they come in Congo, play basketball together with Congolese young people. We can be friends and understand as each other. So I think that is something that Rutten should do to connect that people who many times in their home just talk about Rwandans do this or Congolese do this, there are bad persons, so on. So that changed many. And now when I was with them, I said, "There, we have some uncle who are Rwandans. Why you didn't speak Rwandans language? You are afraid." No, you can say that. You can, I'm Rwandans, I'm Congolese, not a problem. So I think that is a little bit another thing that Rutten should promote in that area, and that is so important because I am also a victim of war, and I know what that means. But it is something that important from any victim is he can decide to forgive and forget and do good thing, or he can decide to become a really bad person. And the big bad person is when a victim thinks that he have right to revenge. And when he think he has right to do that, he can do many bad things because he thinks that it's right because they do that to me, I must do that for them because I have the right to do that. So when we have some young people say, no, we can be together, share this, we are just neighbors. It is impossible to say Rwanda go and Congolese go. So I think that thing can one day stop this cycle of violence in that great lake area. That is, I think, I can say about Rutten Shoots. So there are so many things that people do there, and that is why when I was in Disney, I say that, okay, I am a hero, but I think there are so many heroes in there. You didn't know them. If the day you would meet them, you would see that John is just a little one. Yeah.
I know we have to the airport soon.
Yeah.
John.
Yeah.
But I wanted to, before we wrap up, I just wanted to say thank you for being here. I was very fortunate. I got to spend a little extra time with John, and it has been a real gift.
But I want to finish that to say to you that in behalf of staff of JGI in DRC and many children, so guys, we thank you so much. You don't know what you do for us and for our program. The only thing that we can be proud is that I say every time is one day when I will see my daughter, when she will pass a place or cross an area, people say to them, you know, your daddy do a great thing. That is the folly. And who helped us to do that is you. And really, thank you. And all staff tell me to tell you that really thank you, and we support you. Whatever, we are so far, but we are together with you. This is a big family, JGI. Thank you so much.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Gary.
You're welcome.
For this opportunity.
Okay, I'm decided to go with the K-pop. I have to go to the K-pop.